sweaty. That's all the host is going to remember about me. I get nervous before shows sometimes. Like, not mentally, but physically. I'm kind of like Jesus in that I can turn water into stress diarrhea. It's a miracle. It just goes in and comes out in the same motion. It's like a slip and slide. There's no barricades. It's just a busted dam. Overwhelming. I got a haircut recently. The girl, it was weird because, okay, the woman called me over. She was like this older woman. And first she shook my hand. And I was like, I've never had a hairdresser shake my hand before. Like, are we striking up a deal? Like, first, you ever know someone, like, they just look like a hoarder? They just, like, you can, like, you have so much stuff in your house, I bet. Like, that's probably what's happening. And so she shook my hand. She asked me how I was. And I was like, I'm fine. And then I asked her how she was, and she was like, I'm so tired. And I'm like, you're about to run a bunch of sharp blades across my head. Maybe perk up a little. A little bit about me. I'm 23 years old. I still live with my parents. And I feel no shame about it, but the rest of the world feels it for me, you know? And this room, too, a little. I can kind of feel it. No, but it's good for me, but, you know, it gets heated sometimes. Sometimes it puts a strain on my parents. Like, my dad and I got in this big argument once, just back and forth, until eventually he was like, you're dead to me. And I was like, because that's, like, the worst thing you can say to your son, right? Other than, I'm attracted to you. Or, oh, fuck, I thought you were sleeping. To which I replied, get out of my room, Dad. That's a joke where my father, who's sitting right around there, masturbates in my bedroom. I know. My parents don't molest me. I think, like, that's kind of as sure as you can be about that, if you really think about it. Because if you were molested, you might block it out as a child. You wouldn't find that out until you're like 35 and a therapist digs it out of you. And you're like, well, that explains all of this. So we don't know. Like, unless you've been molested, you're not sure if you've been molested. And that's a tough joke, but if you don't like it, you can just retroactively unexperience it. Theoretically, that solves the problem.
Yes.
Thank you. I've never heard one of those before. It's hard to date when you talk about molestation all the time. But, you know, they say there's plenty of fish in the sea, so I'm out on the water sometimes. I'm on the search for that elusive golden trout. Or, I don't know, what's like an expensive fish? Did any of you know? What was that? Oh, caviar. Yeah, that's good. I was about to say, like, we're an hour from Pike's Place. You don't know any fucking good fish. But yeah. I'll be out on the water, and then I'm looking for that golden trout, and then every time this pale pink salmon with low self-esteem will jump itself into my boat, and I stare at it, and it stares back at me, and I see, like, in the distance, like, this glimmer of, like, I can see the tail, but it's in the distance, it's beckoning for me. But I look back at the salmon, and I'm just like, well, back to shore, this will do. I'm Sunburned Albino. Thank you, guys.